Hello, in this video you will learn the working of Hartley oscillator and Colpitts oscillator. You will also learn how to remember the formulae needed to solve the problems related to these two oscillators. In these two oscillators, the basic unit is a feedback amplifier. And it is also a common emitter amplifier, and it is using self-biasing. So draw a common emitter amplifier with self-bias. So first draw the transistor like this, and for self-biasing amplifier you put RC here. This is the load resistance, and for biasing circuit you put two resistors like this, and you can also use the RE, that is emitter resistance, and you can also use a bypass capacitor CE and connect this to and give plus VCC here and connect these two, and it is grounded, and this is also connected here. So this is the ground. But here you have to provide positive feedback. In the case of Hartley oscillator, you take the output from here. Since this is a common emitter amplifier, you have to take the output at the collector, and this is the coupling capacitor CC, and this output should be given to a feedback circuit which consists of two inductors like this and one capacitor connected across these two inductors, and this is the feedback circuit. You connect the output here and take the output from the feedback circuit and give this to input side. When you are giving to the input side, you use a coupling capacitor and connect here, CC. And these inductors are named as L1 and L2, and the capacitor is C. This ground point should be connected to the midpoint of these two inductors. So this point should be grounded. Midpoint of these two inductors should be grounded. It is very important. So name this terminal as 1 and this terminal as 2 and this terminal as 3. You remember that there is no external input given to the oscillator. Only the output of the amplifier is given to the input side. Now, how an amplifier will work without an input? So an oscillator is basically an amplifier, but it will work without an input. Now, before seeing the working principle, let us draw the circuit for Colpitts oscillator. Here also the circuit is same. First draw a common emitter amplifier with self bias. So connect a collector resistor RC and draw the biasing circuit like this and put an emitter resistor RE, connect all these things properly, and this is plus VCC, connect a capacitor, it is emitter bypass capacitor CE, use coupling capacitor at the output side CC. Similarly, in the input side, you connect a coupling capacitor. And in this case, you connect two capacitors like this and one inductor like this. So these three components form the feedback circuit. So take the output, give it to the feedback circuit like this, and output of the feedback circuit should be connected to the input. Now, this is the ground point, and this center point is also ground. So connect them and ground it. And call this capacitor as C1 and this as C2 and this inductor as L. Since there is only one inductor, you need not put it as L1. You simply call it as L. Similarly, in this case, that is in Hartley oscillator, only one capacitor in the feedback circuit. So you use the symbol C, not C1. So you can observe that in Hartley oscillator, the first letter is H. H is for Henry, that means inductor. So you can remember in this way. In the Hartley oscillator, in the feedback circuit, you have two inductors, H. Similarly, for Colpitts oscillator, the first letter is C. That means it has two capacitors. It is only for remembering, but that is not the reason. When you have two capacitors, in the opposite arm, you will have only one inductor. If you have two inductors like this, the opposite term will have only one capacitor. So like that, you can easily remember the circuits and you can easily draw the circuit. So now, let us see the working principle. Some points are common to both the circuits. That is, when the circuit is powered on, a small amount of noise, that is voltage, will present in the tank circuit. This noise is fed to the input of the amplifier and an output is obtained. This output voltage is again fed to the input of the amplifier through the feedback circuit. This feedback circuit is also called as tank circuit. And this output is amplified. This process repeats until the steady state is reached. At this stage, a sustained oscillation will be obtained and the energy lost in the circuit components is balanced by the energy provided by the amplifier. The basic unit in these two oscillators is a common emitter amplifier. Any input given to the common emitter amplifier is phase shifted by 180 degree in the output side. That means if you give a positive cycle in the input side, you will get a negative cycle. That means there is 180 degree phase shift. At the same time, the input signal is amplified and obtained in the output. This output is fed to the tank circuit or feedback circuit. When the terminal 2 of this feedback circuit is positive, the terminal 1 will be negative. So this circuit introduces another 180 degree phase shift. So the total phase shift is 360 degrees and hence the Barkhausen's first condition is satisfied. By selecting suitable values for L and C, the second condition, modulus of beta A is equal to 1, will also be satisfied. The resistances R1 and R2 are biasing resistors. Here also R1 and R2. These are the biasing resistors. And resistance RE is emitter resistor, which is used to stabilize the bias point, that is Q point. RC is the collector resistor and the CC are coupling capacitors. And CE is the emitter bypass capacitor. Since both the circuits use a tank circuit, that is LC circuit, the resonant frequency of these circuits will be the frequency of oscillation for these circuits. That is, the general formula is F is equal to 1 by 2 pi square root of LC. This is common for all resonant circuits which are using L and C. But in the case of Hartley oscillator, we are using two inductors. So we have to use L equivalent, that will be equal to L1 plus L2. If these two inductors have a mutual inductance, then that can also be added as plus 2M if they are assisting each other. So the formula for frequency of oscillation can be written like this. F is equal to 1 by 2 pi square root of, instead of L, you put L equivalent because there are two inductors. And C is 1, you put only 1C. So this is the frequency of oscillation for Hartley oscillators. But in the case of Colpitts oscillator, there are two capacitors. So here, instead of C, you use C equivalent. But that C equivalent is not C1 plus C2. It is C1, C2 divided by C1 plus C2. The formula for frequency of oscillation can be written as 1 by 2 pi square root of, L is only 1L, so put L, but C is having two capacitors, so you put C equivalent, and C equivalent is given here. You also remember that when you solve the problems, this L1 is the inductor connected to the input side, and L2 is the inductor connected to the output side. That you have to remember. Input side, this is output side, and this is due to mutual inductance. So in the problem, if they don't give mutual inductance, you don't consider this, you take this as zero. Sometimes if they give the circuit, they may put this inductor as L2 and this inductor as L1. So if you blindly use the formulae, here it will not change, but in other formulae it will change. That means in addition to frequency of oscillation, the minimum gain required is HFE, that will be given as L1 plus M divided by L2 plus M. So if this is L2 and this is L1, if you use the same formula, it will be wrong. Actually, this L1 is the inductor connected to the input side. L2 is the inductor connected to the output side. So if they give the circuit and if you interchange that one, you should be careful. So input side inductance divided by output side inductance. Similarly, here the minimum HFE required will be C2 by C1, not C1 by C2. So here output capacitance divided by the capacitance connected to the input side. So when they ask problem by giving a circuit, if they mark this capacitance as C2 and this capacitance as C1, then you should be careful. HFE will be C1 by C2, not C2 by C1. Then for this Colpitts oscillator, you can also remember this formula, that is feedback voltage will be equal to C1 by C2 into V0. Whenever you are having the ratio, you should be careful. C1 is the capacitor connected to the input side. This is capacitor connected to the output side. And voltage gain, AV, is also equal to C2 by C1. You remember that in both cases, for oscillation, beta AV should be equal to 1, where beta is feedback factor.